Hey, our next guests have been making music for the past 16 years, and they're still going strong. Joining us via satellite from New York, John Flansburgh and John Linnell from the musical group They Might Be Giants. Welcome, Johns.
How you doing?
Hello.
Doing well, man. I've been listening to you guys since the days of Flood, and I still can't get Particle Man out of my head. Particle Man, Particle Man.
Our apologies from the band.
Yeah, it's a long time for that. It's a long time to have one song stuck in your head. You know, people may not realize it, but you guys wrote the theme song for the Fox hit show Malcolm in the Middle, right? And you guys won a Grammy for it.
That's exactly right.
Congrats. How do you get a deal like that, to get picked to write a theme song for a television show?
Well, you know, everybody needs a gimmick, and our gimmick is money.
Mm-hmm.
And so they just offered us some cash money, and we said yes, and we gave them the song, and it fit the show pretty well, and it's been a pretty big success for us.
Yeah, it has been, certainly. And your latest CD, No, it was just released yesterday, right?
That's right, yeah.
And it's a bit of a departure, you might say, in that you're calling it a CD for the entire family. What do you mean by that?
Well, there's no swearing on it, which we normally don't have on our grown-up records, but there's also no death imagery.
Yeah.
And there's kind of a, you know, it's generally stuff that you can understand when you've just recently learned how to talk, I think.
And it's also what we call an enhanced CD. So what does that mean? Why is it enhanced? What enhancements have been made to the CD?
Well, basically, you know, we sort of embarked on making a children's record, and we want to make something that would be fun for kids to play with, besides just like putting it on long car trips with their parents and driving their parents crazy. So we worked with this great graphic design group, The Chopping Block, who do all our websites, mm-hmm. and they're very creative guys, and they do all sorts of cool stuff in Flash. And basically, they illustrated all the songs. There's a sing-along bar that you can sort of play a song and sing along to the song as you interact. In some ways, it's a way for kids to learn how to use the mouse, which is a little embarrassing. They're really imaginative scenarios that they've created, though, and a lot of our songs are very noun-driven, so it's a very natural thing to illustrate them.
Yeah, it's super cool. I was playing with it today. In fact, why don't we take a look at this enhanced CD?
Cool.
The name of the CD is called No. Here's Fibber Island. Let's take a look.
Here on Fibber Island, we strum rubber guitars. Our friends live on Mars, and we sew buttons on our cars. Here on Fibber Island, our house is made of pie. Our dog is 2 miles wide, and all he talks about is.
So what goes into creating an enhanced CD track like this? How much of a role did you guys play in designing the graphics?
Very, very little. We have a great working relationship with The Chopping Block, and we really trust their aesthetics and their judgment. And a lot of what was happening in Flash at the time that we were working on this project, which was over a year ago, was just emerging. So they had a much better idea of what the limits of the technology were, which were quite real. I mean, obviously, a lot of things have changed over the past year. But Flash is a very neat program. You can do a lot of things with it. But I think working with a company that combines really good graphic design and illustration and animation and has a really good grasp of the technology is kind of a must for people like us.
Yeah, what people might not realize just by looking at that little video we played is the whole thing is really interactive. It's, like you said, using the mouse.
Right.
By clicking things on there, you're making things happen on the video.
Right.
That's right. Yeah, well, we noticed that young kids who have already figured out how to point and click just tend to experiment, you know. I mean, that's the kind of thing that really appeals to kids who are just roaming around with the mouse, just clicking on whatever they want. You know, they don't really have this sense of it having to be a particular way at that age. And so it's kind of designed around that.
Yeah, I don't know if it's really limited to kids either. You know, I think I could do a pretty compelling post-structuralist reading of Fibber Island.
Yes.
Of course.
We are eagerly anticipating that.
GiantKid.net. It's a companion site for the album. What can we find there?
Well, it has a lot of the things that are on the record, sort of in smaller versions. But if you've got a fast connection, there's a lot of entertainment there. It basically previews the whole record.
Mm-hmm. Here, we're taking a look at it right now. Do you think now that you've done this one, you'll be doing more enhanced CDs down the road, even if you don't do another kids album, one for adults?
Yeah, well, actually, we've been doing a lot of things in Flash. You know, we give away a tremendous amount of stuff. If people out there are into free stuff, we want to encourage them to sign up for our email list at any of our sites, because we will send you free MP3s and also these great e-cards that are essentially Flash animations. There's a really cool one at tmbg.com of a rock song called Cyclops Rock that it came out really great. The people at Chopping Block are amazing, you know, people to work with.
So Chopping Block, just to reiterate, that's the name of the Flash studio that did all this?
Yeah.
Right, they're the designers.
All right, well, they did a great job. All right, hold on, we're not done with They Might Be Giants yet. When we return, find out how the Johns design their websites, hear their stance on file sharing, and we're going to tell you more about how you can get free They Might Be Giants MP3s